My name is Foxer Nine-Tailed, aka 9-Bit Fox. I'm here to tell you about a series of unfortunate events that takes place on a world filled with stupid people, as well as very, very depressing scenes, some twists in there that just make it all even more depressing, yet all has a very somewhat good story that is also being told within it, and also being narrated while also giving bits and pieces to it. Yeah, that's about it. You don't know how many freaking times I had to freaking do that take. Oh, one minus Fox. When I told Megan Evan Fox, I did the whole little Lemony Snicket opening, but Evan. That took way too freaking long for that one take. Hopefully I'm not blowing out your freaking ears, because I had to raise up the game, because the last couple videos, like, my voice was, like, super low, and I had to, like, raise it up in the audio thing. Hopefully now it's a little bit better, and if anything, I just lower the volume. But, I just finished watching Lemony Snicket and a Series of Unfortunate Events. The TV series, not the movie. I was a little bit on edge with this for a little bit, this show for a little bit, because I kind of seen the trailers, and it has, Neil Patrick Harris, I'm trying to remember his name. Neil Patrick Harris playing Count Olaf, the first caretaker of these three orphan children who were born to two people that were in a secret society that have to do with this eye thing, and that you slowly kind of figure out, they're slowly trying to tell you the story of what's going on. And there's, like, connections between Count Olaf and the family. And Count Olaf wants the kids because of their fortune. So he has to go through all these dastardly things to try to get the money. But the money is locked away until the oldest girl is 18 or of age. And, what was it? I'm trying to think of everything that happened in this series. Well, not everything that happened. Just trying to quick synopsis. But, basically, the kids are super smart. Everyone in this world is incredibly stupid. Where I'm just like, just let them live by themselves. I'm pretty sure they'll survive. I'm pretty sure they'll survive by themselves. They can find a way. They can invent a bunch of crap. Ugh. And basically it goes from them going from kind of household to household, being passed around different caretakers, as they're slowly trying to figure out what the heck was with their parents, what are the secret society. There's like these two spies, and there's these two people, I'm not going to spoil it, but when you find out who they are a little bit, well, not really who they are, kind of who they are, it's kind of like, what the fuck? I won't spoil too much on this series, but I'll say because I've seen the movie, I haven't rewatched it since. I haven't rewatched it since, like, a long time ago. I don't even really remember how the movie ended. Because, from what I know, and I'm pretty sure the series is the same, they took the first three books, I believe, of the series, and they crammed it together into a movie. And this one, they took the first three books, and they made it into, there are two episodes of these eight, no, there's eight episodes, so that's not right. Four books, maybe, then. Because it was the first two with Count Olaf, the second with the lizard people, the lizard guy, crazy aunt, and then the mill. So about, four different ones. And basically, that's kind of the synopsis of it. Olaf wants, Count Olaf wants the Baudelaire's fortune, the three main kids. Three main kids are smart and trying to outsmart him, not in a coyote roadrunner kind of way, but more in a sense of, this guy's going to kill people for our money, and he's going to make us be very miserable. And also, he's apparently an actor, Count Olaf, and he has plenty of disguises that he uses, from a sea captain to a secretary to Stefano. stupid. I love stupid. but the series is freaking How the fuck? One, it has, because you're being also being narrated by this guy, Lemony Snicket, which I first thought was the author, which I think maybe is the author, maybe isn't, I don't know. But Lemony Snicket, which is played by that one deep voice dude, I can't remember all their name, I'm sorry, actor's name, I can't really remember, but he talks very in a monotone style like this, but very deep voice. And he's like talking about like the Baudelaire's, the case of the Baudelaire's, like what happened to them. And he's saying bad things always happen to the Baudelaire's, and this is not a happy tale. It ends badly. And the Baudelaire's like have so many, like, first off, you're like, okay, they get taken to this judge, this nice lady who's kind of dumb. This world is filled with stupid people. If you have a problem with stupid characters, you're just like, oh my lord, you're a freaking moron, or something like that, you're probably not gonna like this series. Maybe you will, I don't know. They are funny at times, but a lot of the points, I'm kind of getting into this, I'm just thinking, these poor kids, they just want to find somewhere to live. And everyone is completely and utterly stupid. And what do I mean by that? I mean, like, oh, Lord, fudge me. I mean, like, the Count Olaf is a terrible person, and he treats this one judge who would have been a great caretaker for the kids, but for some reason they are not given to him, though I guess it's kind of explained a little bit, but, given to her, this judge, but this judge is a very nice person, and Count Olaf is just a complete utter a-hole to her, and she believes everything that Count Olaf is telling her, like, oh, the kids don't want to see you because they're a-holes, yeah, they're just rich kids, and all this stuff, and, like, she believes it, or Count Olaf's trying to trick them into, trying to trick into a marriage at one point, and she goes along with it and doesn't, and you and the kids say, you're trying to take our fortune, and she's like, shut up, I'm trying to study my lines. I was like, oh my god, you're a freaking idiot. There's Count Olaf at one point appears like the snake guy. And FYI, this show spoils itself multiple times. Though I guess it's kind of understandable, and it kind of fits the entire narrative. Like, nothing good is coming from this. Like, literally, the theme song usually spoils what the fudge is going to happen in the series, or what's going to happen in the episode that it's going to be in, or I'll say chapters, because it's like part one and part two of one chapter, and the part one and part two of the second chapter, and stuff like that. But it's like, my lord, it's freaking annoying. It's freaking annoying. Watching all of these idiots, because like they know this guy's a bad guy. Even though the lizard guy thought it was someone else, but still stupid. He's like, we know this guy's a bad guy. He chased the kids up and down the stairs with a knife. That's a thing that happens in this, and the guardian knows this. Not Count Olaf, it's after Count Olaf. But this guardian knows this. And he still lets this person in his house and saying that he's going to be his, not apprentice. What the fudge is it called? Not apprentice, lab assistant. And I'm just thinking, you can just kick him out. He doesn't have to be there. You can kick him out. But then again, this is coming from a standpoint of, you know, thinking. Where no one does in this, and when I say the people are stupid, that's not a knock against the show itself. It's stupid because the characters are written to be stupid, and not in a stupid way. And how do I explain that? Fudge me. If you understand, thank you. But what I mean in a sense is like, you know, you write a horror film, and the guy's like, I hear a chainsaw downstairs. I'm gonna go check it out. Something like that. Or like, we're in this haunted house where this murderer is trying to kill us. I'm gonna take a shower. Something like that. I can't remember if that was a movie or a dream I had. I don't know. I've had some effed up horror dreams. Ah, jeez. Fudge me. Madge is also... Ah, never mind. Forget what I said. Probably not, because, you know, you didn't record this. You rewind this. I think I edited it out, but I'm not going to. Ah, fudge me. Actually, I didn't think that was a dream. Off topic. Off topic. Anyways. That's kind of what I mean. Like, if they're not written... Well, that's written stupidly, as in stupid, like... He's an immortal guy who has a giant sword, giant knife that's gonna stab you. I'm gonna go poke him. No. It's more along the lines of, these characters are written to be stupid, to be kind of funny, in a sense. But also, I guess kind of funny, but they're also supposed to be very, just very stupid. And watching this, I'm just like, okay, what the fuck. And also, like, watching this, I do remember some of the movie. And I feel like they probably did watch the movie, and some were like, and maybe the books also have the style, maybe on the covers, I don't know. But like, it looks like it's taking kind of like a visual aids from, kind of from the movie, at least from what I remember. Maybe there are like drawings in the books that like, you know, they could took them from, but I don't know. But things like that, like, it feels like they kind of did a visual of that. A bit rich. It's it, and there's a lot of funny jokes in this. Though I will say, Neil Patrick Harris, when I first saw him as dressed up as Count Olaf, I'm just like, what the fudge is he wearing? Because I'm just like, I don't know, it just looks weird. His head looks like it's like too big when he has like the thing. I'm just like, I actually kind of like the Jim Carrey's Olaf in there. What the fudge is Jim Carrey doing? Why did they bring him back? But but Neil Patrick Harris does a very good job afterward. Does a very good job, especially when he's doing the other personalities and stuff. That's actually, like, pretty awesome. I think the weakest one I really did, the weakest personality that he plays as is Count Olaf. A little bit. But then again, I don't know. No, I still like it. I still like it. But it is kind of weird seeing him with, like, that, like, bald cap thing, and it makes his head look a little too big. Also, FYI, they probably didn't put a lot. They put money into this, but there is like some bad CGI stuff like that. But then again, it feels kind of part of its charm, I guess. I don't know. it feels a little like it is like, you know, low grade CG, but it's all right in the case. Olaf's henchmen are freaking hilarious. The guy with the hooks, it's just so stupid. Oh my god. But then, like, I really do like the idea of all this, because there's, like, three to four different storylines going on in this. There's the Baudelaire kids and Olaf trying to steal their fortune. There's this secret society, one with, like, these two spies trying to help the Baudelaires get to Peru at one point, or get to these different things, and like the different caretakers, they say something else, my friend, what they were called, different caretakers are all part of this organization, but each of them has kind of changed, and like, slowly you are given clues on like, that Olaf is a spoiler, I guess, a little bit, I don't know, and there's way more twists in this, but, especially the one with, two others. Oh my lord. That just like disheartened me so badly at the end. Like the last two episodes when they show what's behind the yellow door. That was like, I watched that. I'm like, oh, ow, ow, you mother flubber. You gave me depression. Fudge. Ah. Ow! I don't want to say disheartened. Shut up! It's Tim Markiplier upload a new video. Gonna watch that later. Ah, find me. Okay, so think. Where was that? You slowly get like little bits and pieces that Olaf was part of this group and that everyone was together. And like, you kind of understand this a little bit when, what is it? They talk about, there's a picture of a piano, and like the lizard character goes, me and your family were close friends. Me and your parents were close friends. Taps the picture of the piano. It's just a little piano, and they're like, that's not a picture of our parents. That's a piano. And like, and the guy, this guy's like, yeah, we're trapped in the piano. Yeah, we're locked in the piano. And I'm just like, okay. And though, like, the thing is, I'll bring it up. Oh, the thing is, like, they there's a couple of twists in this show, and it puts you on so much effing ease. And that is a very good thing about this show. Oh, I hate this show, but I love this show because I hate it. Alex, I don't know. Hold on. How long have I been going for? 18 minutes. Okay. Sorry, I just need to double check. I don't want these reviews to go too long. But, but, like, there's a lot to it. And, like, again, like, this piano, like, you're like, okay, this could just be a complete utter lie or something like that. But then again, in this world, I don't know that. In this world, they could be locked in the piano. And it turns out they are. Because Olaf later on says, after he's chasing the kid, he's like, I'm gonna take your money. Something like that about your parents. He taps the picture of the piano, and the kid's like, "That's a picture of a piano." And they're saying, "No, your parents are locked inside." And he's like, "How do you know that?" And they're like, "I took the picture." Things like that, or like the ankle tattoo that Olaf has. It always appears on the different things or whatnot. It always appears like everywhere, showing like part of the secret society. Which so far I'm, and also Lemony Snicket is actually brought up a couple times, and like, I thought he was dead, I thought he was this, but he's also researching the murders, and apparently he faked his death, and he's on the run. And like, there's these secret tunnels all around the world that are marked by this eye thing that the secret society has around everywhere for some reason. This world is a cartoony fucking world. Where everyone is stupid. But the thing is, that's kind of the brilliance of this. Because, again, the lizard caretaker. When you first meet him, you're like, fudge, this guy could be incredibly evil. From everything they show, like the picture with the piano. But, you know, you don't see the parents. It puts you on ease. It doesn't make... This show makes you feel like something bad is going to happen. Heck, in the beginning of the freaking thing, again... The theme song literally tells you, go away! This show is going to depress you! This show will ruin your day! This show is not... There's nothing good gonna happen in this show! And I'm starting to believe it! Fuck! Oh. My thought on this... It's a really good show. It has a lot of good twists in it. It has a lot of funny moments. Like, one point where like, they're saying they're going to go to the movie theater. And Count Olaf goes, why would you want to go to a movie theater? You can say... You can watch television and movies in the comfort of your own home. And then looks to the camera. And then looks back. And I'm just like, okay. I've seen Fourth Wall Breaks and he just broke it. But that was actually kind of funny. And the baby is freaking hilarious, even though she never says anything. She says nothing. But when she has, like, when she goes, and that, and then they put, like, a caption of, like, what she supposedly said. And it's always a smart butt remark, like, lady's, like, crazy. And she's like, she needs help. Or, like, oh, Lord, not again. Or such cartoony things, like, at one point, a certain character you think is dead... Because they jumped out a window, supposedly. And instead of it just being a broken, shattered, like, window, it is the cartooniest outline of a person jumping out of a glass window where the glass stayed perfectly. Of the thing. That was probably in the movie, too. But I saw that. I just busted out loud. I'm like, what cartoony world am I looking at? Gosh dang it. This show is so... and that's why it's... I hate this show because I'm pretty sure nothing good is coming. It's all bad things happening to these poor kids. There's all these bad things happening, but you're also interested, like, because you kind of want something good to happen. You watch it because you want to see something good to happen. And then you also want to follow it because of this storyline with Lemony Snicket, which you learn stuff about Lemony Snicket, where you're like, okay, why the fuck am I learning something about the narrator? And you learn how the narrator's actually part of the story himself. And then, fudge me. Gosh dang it. Trying to think. I'm trying to think. Lemony Snicket and a series of unfortunate events. I hate it because it makes you feel these feelings of you want these kids to do well. Like, it's kind of like watching Bob's Burgers in a sense, where it's kind of like, oh, there's a chance they could be rich. You know, it's not gonna happen because they want to continue the series, and if they're rich. Sorry, I'm just watching my audio. So it was kind of like, okay, yeah. But this is a TV series. Yeah, they're extending it out too. But it's kind of like, you want to see something good happen. You want to see, like, these spy people, like, take these kids away from Count Olaf, from all this crap. You want to see them happy, but you can never do that. And it's just so sad. And then everyone being stupid doesn't help. Because you're just like, just listen to the kids. It makes you feel these emotions of sadness and a little bit of depression when bad things happen to these kids. But you also root for them when good things happen. There's things that, like, it seems like it could go right. And again, like Bob Burgers, all right, that is a pretty funny show. But in the sense, I can always watch that show and know nothing good is going to come in that show for this family. They're going to be stuck in that same apartment. Above that burger shop. That burger shop is not going to be very well liked. Or it's only going to have a few customers and stuff like that. You know, I feel like when I watch the show, that's kind of what I know is going to happen. And probably is going to keep happening for a couple years. One thing Steven Universe. Like, I actually like that one. Like, what? Greg's rich. And they don't get rid of it the first the episode that he's rich. Or the second episode he's rich. They actually let him keep being rich throughout the rest of the series, hopefully. And it's kind of something like that. Watching this, it's kind of like, I want something, but this one is like, I want something good to happen, something to help them, but it doesn't. And it's just like, fun! And there are some differences from the movie, like, in this one, the kids have to read a lot, and also everyone has a library. In this series, like, all of their caretakers, no matter who they are, they always have a library. And I'm pretty sure it probably is supposed to, like, kind of symbolize parts of the caretaker. Because, like, you know, the lizard library, it's full of lizard books and stuff about lizards and stuff like that. And different things, like the poison and stuff like that. Or reptiles. Then you have the grammar nut. She has books about grammar and all this stuff. And each time they slowly, the boulders are learning bits and pieces. Or the last one, the mill, where, like, it's just the same book over and over and over again. Like, there are libraries in all chapters of this. Even like the judge had her own about laws and stuff. And I'm pretty sure there's some kind of symbolism or, like, things like these guardians are kind of helping them, even though they're, you know, not. I don't know. If you don't like stupid characters, like, if they make you cringe and really, like, kind of hurts you a little bit, you're probably not gonna like this show, because, oh my lord, it is filled with stupid characters. But if you can get, and again, they're written like that. It's supposed, and there are a lot of funny moments you get from it, but some of them is just like, fudge me, and love. I don't know, Count Olaf, whatever it is, Count Olaf, or like Neil Patrick Harris as Count, dressed as Count Olaf, he's kind of funny, but they're also stupid, and there's also a thing about words, which actually I kind of like that in the beginning, it's a quick tangent, I'm going to end this soon, but in the beginning of the series, there's a thing about like words, like definitions, like, oh, your family has perished, that means they died, or something like that. And it's like words you know, and slowly as the story progresses, they start coming up with bigger words that, like, you don't know, and I think the show's trying to make me feel stupid. I'm watching, I'm like, I get all these words, this entire world, these people are all stupid.
And you slowly see it, like, there's even definitions of these words. But then, as the story progresses, they start coming out with bigger words, words out of the nowhere. And I'm just like, you're trying to make me feel stupid, show, aren't you? Trying to make me feel stupid! Ah, jeez. And it's really good. It leaves it off a good cliffhanger. And, like, there's even, like, I don't know, maybe a little spoiler for the end. There's, like, a little song at the end where, like, all the characters sing. And it's very sad and depressing. But, yeah, if you don't like stupid characters that make you cringe and hurt, or just, like, it isn't something that you, like, I don't know. I don't want to say, like I'm like the person in the movie theater who's, like, yelling and screaming, like, I'm gonna go kill you! So, like, that bullcrap, no. But this show made me yell at it because I was just like, fudge! Just let the kids go! Let the kids stay with this! Kick the man out! Just run! Fudge me! Anyways, I've gone on for too long. I hope I haven't gone for an hour. But, yeah, but if you can get past that, there's a really good story that's being told to you bit by bit. There's the story of the spies. There's the mystery of the secret society. There's the story of the kids with freaking being chased by Count Olaf all around the freaking world, while also slowly getting bits and pieces on who Count Olaf is to these kids and to their family. What about their parents? Stuff like that. Either way. My name is Foxer Ninetailed, aka Ninebit Fox. The series of unfortunate events is a very good show, but full of twists and characters and these three kids that you like, but full of stupid, stupid characters. If you like such stories, watch this, but be warned, it may ruin your day with full-on depression. But either way, we will see you in the next video. That's Markiplier's thing! We'll see you later!